Hi and welcome to part three. This time I'm just going to play some time on another set of cymbals. I'm going to just describe them as brilliant K thins. There's a 22 ride, a 19 crash ride, and a pair of 14 inch hi-hats. Their feature is that they're thin, and also they're kind of low but with a lot of punchy stick sound. They have small bells, which I think is like part of the a significant part of the deal, because you get this sort of traditional sound out of them, and you get a ding, okay, with that kind of small cup. I'd just like to talk a little bit about how to kind of work a cymbal. I know there's a lot of guys out there that, you know, kind of maybe figure that changing the cymbal is going to get them what they want. But I'd just like to accentuate a little bit of sort of experience. This is what I've learned. People passed it on to me. I'm going to pass it on again. Apologies to those of you out there who know this. But sticks, the end of the stick, the ball end, is really important to the sound that you get from the cymbal. And you can have a cymbal which can sound completely different depending on which stick you use and the way you use that stick. Now, I'm not proposing that a cymbal should be an entirely different entity, because we're looking for a more integrated kind of concept of what the drum kit has to offer. But I'm just going to say that if you're out there predominantly working on cymbals or trying to get a better cymbal sound, consider the stroke that you're using. Experiment. Again, it's up to you to find your own way of doing things. But what I'm going to suggest is if you kind of work into the cymbal, you know, it doesn't have to be any kind of particularly sort of, you know, new funky idea. You can feel this for yourself and you find your own feel, but work into the cymbal. It will bring out all the tone of the cymbal. It'll make best use of the stick. Hopefully that's the stick that you've chosen that you like, because it brings the best tone from the cymbal. It's easy to play. It has a good feeling. My favoured application is to have kind of an oval sort of sweep into the cymbal. It works the tone out of the metalwork. So I'll just demo. Exactly the same when you play the swing rhythm. Hopefully what you've noticed is I'm not playing flat out. I'm not hitting anything really hard. I'm just trying to induce energy into the cymbal. This is really important, because if you figure the thing is just going to sit on a stand and you're just going to be able to go donk, and that's all there is to it. You'll be surprised over a period of time as you learn to develop your cymbal playing technique, you'll get sweeter sounds, you'll get more contrast and more textures, and hopefully a happier cymbal. So there we are. Remember, it's a handmade thing. I'll see you later. Thanks for listening, and I hope you've enjoyed the presentation. See you in London.